Got a question for the escapist? Send us an email. Better yet, send us a video of yourself asking us the question, and we might put it on the air. Send us a 15-second or less video to this address down here, tes@escapistmag.com. Could be anything. Who's my hairdresser? What kind of shoes do I wear? Why didn't we ask the guy we were interviewing about that one game that's your favorite game in the world? Why didn't we ask him the only question he wanted to hear? Videotape yourself asking us that. 15 seconds or less.
15 seconds.
We might put it on the show. And you'll get a badge in our forum so everybody will know you're a video star.
This week, we'll get first look at Red Alert 3 for PS3.
Duh!
The time has come to crush the Allies.
Duh!
We will use our mighty communist might.
Duh!
Duh!
The plans. On this big board for great armored time traveling Ruski bear.
Oh! What does it do?
Comrade Rusinski, the particulars of the armored time traveling bear plot are of no concern to us. We will crush the Allies regardless!
Nah.
But if it does not work, how then will we crush Allies?
Even if it does not work, we will have created great armored time-traveling bear gap.
We've crushed them!
This good plan. You will go along.
I cannot deny this superior communist logic. Let us see this great armored time-traveling bear then.
Bring bear. Comrades, I present Ruski Bear! You will clip, Comrade Brzezinski.
Watch this video and learn from it.
Do you think you can handle it?
All your base arm. All your base arm. All your base arm. All your base arm belong to us.
Red Alert 3 shipped for the PC and Xbox 360 in the fall just last year, and the PS3 team was able to take the additional time to make some improvements and add some extra features and stuff that's gonna make it worthwhile, hopefully, worth the wait. In the case of Red Alert 3, it was one of the things that was convenient from the perspective of our fiction is that the story is all around the Soviets kind of meddling with time. So at the very beginning of the game, they do something that basically alters the course of history and resets the story's timeline. So because of that, no previous experience is really expected of the player. You could come into this game having never played a Command and Conquer game or a Red Alert game and kind of understand what's going on as well as anyone. In the campaign, it's all story driven for the most part. You guys are part of the same faction, though there are a few points in the story where there is cross faction play. It really varies based on mission, exactly what you do, and we try to get a good amount of variety in there, where you're both, sometimes you're kind of back-to-back having to hold off kind of a slew of forces all trying to do you in, or other times both players are trying to pursue independent objectives that and kind of meet in the middle. So we got to explore a lot of cool material there that made the process of designing the campaign missions very different from what this team is used to from working on previous games like Command and Conquer 3 and Battle for Middle-Earth 2. So the design team got to bite off kind of a whole new set of challenges. It was very important to us to not sacrifice the single player experience for the sake of the co-op, because single player is still how people are used to playing games like this for the most part. So when you're playing solo through the campaign, you work alongside an AI-controlled co-commander character. So if you and I were to play, you would replace that character. Otherwise, it's kind of some sort of colorful character from the Red Alert universe to give you a little more sense of what the people in this world are really like.
We have done a lot of work to take advantage of the hardware that the PS3 has. We have enhanced graphically a lot of things in the game, from most noticeably the water renderer, which we went back to the very complex, highly modeled water render from the PC. It's pretty spectacular looking. Some more subtle things, we were able to increase the resolution of many of the textures in the games, from cliff walls to scorch marks to some of the VFX that occur in the game. Subtly, we remastered the full screen movies with a higher bit rate compression to take advantage of the disk space that we have on Blu-ray. So it's quite an enhanced HD experience.